Sameh Abeta-san, it's a pleasure to catch up with you here in Madrid at the Fyuz event. There have been a number of interesting conversations in day one and day two around really the progress of Open RAN and disaggregated networking in general, but I'd love to hear your thoughts. Abeta-san, maybe we can start with you. It seems like we're moving from the focus on interoperability and lab testing to actual scaled deployments.
Yes. So DoCoMo case, first we do that interoperability test is that it's a clearly lab test. Because that the first we need to check the very basic functionality. So then we move to that, going to the stability test and raw data test. This is also we done in the lab. Because that it's very hard to see that what happened in the field. So we do that test as much as possible in lab first. And actually we deploy that 5G in commercial. We are now doing that. Actually, it's a commercial, not a test. But of course, we see that the additional things during my field or commercial. And of course, we will feedback to and how we can improve that that equipment. So that is current process, yeah.
And then Sammy, help us understand this sort of transition. Obviously, the radio systems need to be hardened in the lab so that the operators have confidence as they deploy. But when we think about Open RAN as a platform for innovation, as a dynamic programmable network, you get into this paradigm where there's continuous testing. So how does this work in practice?
It's a very good question because traditionally you're right, people always test, oh, here is the element, here is what you need to test it, and then you harden it and you go there. But the whole idea of openness is the ability to bring in other innovative ideas. And that requires that the testing has to be programmable too, right? It's not just one step in time. And even I will add to it, it also have to be more realistic than before, because this is where, the idea of bringing some of the real case scenarios with real data and then see how Open RAN can improve that. I think this is where a lot of the attraction of Open RAN is that it brings in this platform for innovation. But again, it brings in also complexity, right? So the testing has to work between the two, right? What part of it is the complexity you need to make it simplified for the innovation to happen, but at the same time, providing the innovation with the ability to test these ideas, right? And expand on it. I always say that, the best innovation is the one that when you start working on it, you'll open up more innovation, right? So that's what the dynamic part of the test. And one of the things I think, as Abeta-san was saying in his speeches today and yesterday, is that now we're taking this into realistic behavior. It's not just talks anymore. You're seeing with OREX and a lot of these platforms now, it's actually grounding it, right? Making it really true so people can have more confidence that they can build on that.
Tell us a little bit more about your keynote yesterday, Abeta-san. I think you and I have been discussing Open RAN in various forms for 3 to 4 years at this point, and there's always been this lingering question about whose job is it to do the integration piece. So DoCoMo's new services brand, maybe you can give us an overview?
Yep. So the Open RAN is that the integration is quite new for the most of the operator because that they use that the integrated solution in the past. So Open RAN, we need additional integration. That's then how we can simplify or how we can reduce the cost of the integration. That is actually important. So then OREX try to share the integration cost among the operators. And also additional staff resources needed if they do the integration by themselves. So on behalf of that, the operators, we do the integration and provide the pre-integration solution. Then they don't need to that lab, they don't need to that the additional resource, and they don't have the expert. But so we can help them. Well, so we need that additional test equipment.
See, but this is all very good, very indicative of the progress, I think, as these machinations become more replicable, more scalable, then we can really start to focus on innovation and automation. And Sammy, you and I have discussed before this concept of a digital twin of a network, right? But maybe you can lay that out for our audience.
So that's exactly the point. I mean, the beauty about Open RAN and blueprints like OREX and actually giving a guideline for operators. Now they have a guide how to do this, and they can actually do it with confidence. Now the question is, how can you build a digital replica of this network to open this innovation. One is to help get more confidence. I mean, the problem always with Open RAN is, can I be confident? Can I do it with confidence? I mean, you know, there is history of, you know, things that have been done before with processes. Now we're saying you're gonna have to change. So there's a lot of this resistance to, you know, can I be confident? So the digital twin is gonna give them this confidence, number one. But it also opens it up for really now innovation, because, okay, now I know it's working, now I need people to open the opportunity to bring in new players. Maybe they never have the whole picture of the network. Now they can actually test as if they are running in a real network, right? And that's new. This is with Open RAN, with a lot of the software, a lot of the testing now, integration with the automation, with the orchestration. Now you can build something like that. And I think this is where the future of networking is gonna be going, you know, building a lot of these digital twin. I actually say, believe it, they will build it in real time, where you actually bring in real data from the real network to feed the digital twin. So it's continuously behaving more and more like a real network, right? Now you add AI to it, and now you can actually ask the digital twin, what if I do this? Now it's gonna respond to you as if a real network responding to you. That is, it's a lot of complexity there, because it requires a lot of data and how you can build this kind of realistic behavior. But that's, I think this is the exciting part of the digital twin.
And Sameh, you mentioned this idea of a guide. I will encourage our audience to look for VIAVI's definitive guide to Open RAN,
right,
which
yes.
was recently published.
Yes.
It's an excellent, excellent way to familiarize
right. yes.
yourself
yes.
with where we are today, where we're going.
Right.
But now, gentlemen, I would maybe ask you for some summary thoughts for the people that could not join us here at Fyuz. Just what do you think the key takeaway is? Abeta-san, we'll start with you.
Yes, one is that the operators' collaborations. So they're talking with the operators. They are not so sure how they deploy the Open RAN in commercial. And so we share their experience. So then they end up talking with them, and so deployment scenarios Open RAN, how it's beneficial for that, for their network. So from our experience, that is one thing I think that we can help that the operators. And the other thing that we have that shared Open RAN. So if they want to see that performance of the VLAN, our open share lab, they can access remotely from their site. Then they don't need to come to our office or even the Fyuz. Just from their site, their office, they can. So that office can change that lab using that our remote lab.
And Sameh, summary thoughts?
Yes, I mean, I agree with Barasan. I mean, this is, we are now in a time where it's becoming more practical. A good news I can share with everyone, we are seeing a lot of cooperation, a lot of people talking to each other, a lot of different part of the industry, you know, building this ecosystem. I mean, that's a great example with OREX, a lot of the ecosystem now giving more confidence. I think this is gonna open the opportunity for also providing a lot of services. I think this is something that the industry is looking for, building these services so that you don't have to worry about building your own lab. You can use something like OREX and you can, you know, get the confidence. We can actually add more services. We're working with partnership with other to build more services and adding these services. And I think this is the road for what we're gonna see next. I mean, this is not the end of the story. This is just the beginning of the story. I mean, we're seeing a lot of new innovations coming, you know, even discussing 6G, although it's a little bit area, but there is a lot of innovation. I always say that it is it's the 0.5G that tells you what the G is gonna look like, right? So we are in this 0.5G right now. We're in this area where we're bringing a lot of innovations, we're taking it to the next step, and that will give you a glimpse of what is coming, you know, in 5-6 years from now.
Excellent, gentlemen. Thank you so much for
thank
sharing
you.
Your time and your perspective
you.
With me and our audience.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.